yellow, black. And song, when I heard it on the radio, I said, this song right here is the song of all songs. And Aloe, he gonna be a little bit soft in the background, but we gonna let him bring it to y'all attention.
I've been surfing at a job in a world that tries to own me.
You know, people say a lot of things, but Aloe seems to bring it to home plate. And we are the ones he's trying to have follow. People say I'm mad in my face. I don't care. I'm gonna do it my way. Ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna let Aloe play in my background and your background. Okay? Because we got something we want to show y'all. Hey, I'm gonna do it what? There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, these videos are being done what? My way. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, the Chicago Style Manuals. I just got off the phone with an individual saying he wanted to do a consult. We had a conversation. Conversation went on into other things, but he said, I said something in one of my older videos that got something brought into his attention. Ladies and gentlemen, he sent me to this video right here. And I'm sorry, but you know I don't promote videos, but I'm going to promote this video right here because this gentleman right here, he's basic. He's just giving you information. Now, it's the Justinian deception, okay? This Justinian deception video right here, I'm promoting. Capital A-N hyphen older, O-L-D-E-R, all capitalized, and the code. And you know, he points out something in this video, and he's absolutely right. Hold on, let's do this. Do it my way, Aloe. I want you to hold on right there, Aloe. We're going to get right back to you in a second. Ladies and gentlemen, I want y'all to hear what this gentleman has to say. Hey.
The administrative part of the Western world, or the corporate world, the Holy See, I guess you could say, the law of shipping, merchant shipping. In this book, it clearly states that, well, a degree of this,
hold on,
is sign language.
We're gonna go back. Wanted to get the whole video because my screen wasn't showing everything, and I want you guys to see everything. This is from the movie Madagascar, Kenya Wildlife Preserve in Africa. Now, we would think that that's English. You think that that's English. We know that there's a difference between legalese and English. We know that legalese and English are not the same thing. He's going to make a statement in here, and we're going to focus on that statement only. We don't care about the rest of the video. This one particular statement is what we're going to focus on. But I want you to pay attention to what goes on in the movie Madagascar, and he is correct when he brings this up. Can you read? Hold on. Come on.
But as Phil says in this movie, he sees it exactly as it is, as sign language, and it's no part of the English language.
Wait, ladies and gentlemen, it is a sign. It's language on a sign. It is sign language. It's so simple. It's so basic. And it's so obvious. Now, so even I can learn something. Hold on.
Can you read?
Can you read?
Phil can read, though.
Hey, where's Phil?
Ship to Kenya. Wildlife Preserve, Africa.
Hold on, y'all. Do you realize? He was doing sign language. Sign language is not English. It's called the American Sign Language. It is not English. He was doing sign language. He read the sign, and he used sign language to interpret the sign to someone else. No, hold on. Let me let the young man explain something to you.
I think I can prove Phil the monkey right, because I've spent the last 10 years trying to prove that this all uppercase text is English, and I just cannot find the evidence to prove this.
Ladies and gentlemen, I can guarantee you, for the life of me, there are no English words spelled in all capital letters. I can guarantee you that. I can guarantee you that there are no English words spelled in all capital letters. It defies all grammatical principles. It defies it. Impossible. Like I said, he's about to say something, not out of his mouth, but he's about to prove it to you. Watch.
So, after great looking, so after a lot of research and looking, the Chicago Manual of Styles, which is the official styles manual for the City of London.
Now, wait a minute. As I told all of you, many of you are watching a lot of videos. You're listening to a lot of people. And these people you're listening to, they're not showing you nothing. They're just talking. Stop it. What the is wrong with you? If a person's not proving to you or showing you what they're talking about, stop listening to them. Make them show you what they're talking about, the same as I'm showing you his video, pointing out that he's showing you everything. He's showing it to you and then giving you an explanation for what he's talking about. Now, it's up to you to determine whether or not the information is reliable. Hold on. Let's let him finish.
The administrative part of the Western world, or the corporate world, the Holy See, I guess you could say, the law of shipping, merchant shipping. In this book, it clearly states that a degree of this is sign language, American Sign Language, or ASL. And the three lines of page 666 of this book.
Now, mind you, the number 666, and that's what made him remember this, is because I mentioned in Revelation, the 13th chapter, verse 16 through 18, it speaks about the beast, and it has a name and a mark and a number. And it says that the identity of this beast is a name, a mark, and a number. So we know that the beast is not legitimately a tangible thing. It does exist, but it is figurative, the description of it. That's how you are to identify it, the same as he's identifying this. It's a name, a mark, and a number. It's not literal. So the number 666 is not literal, but some people hold on to it. So he turned to page 666. Don't know why he turned to page 666, but you're going to find out when he did. And like you said, 10 years. So he realized that they put this on page 666 intentionally. They did it intentionally. Why? Because they wanted to get your attention. What he says at the very beginning of this video is that you'll see they put things in movies, blockbusters especially. Because they cannot do anything without giving people notice. Everybody's seen Madagascar. I've seen Madagascar twice. I remember this thing, but I didn't pay any attention to it. Can you read? Is what he says. Ladies and gentlemen, oh God, I didn't know how to read. You're going to see how none of you knew how to read either. Unless you've seen this video, even if you've seen it, you might have missed this part that I'm about to highlight. One second.
As I've stated many times before, on page 666 of this book, these three lines here of text explains that no two languages on a document, two foreign languages foreign to each other, can have jurisdiction with each other.
Wait a minute. What the? if there are two separate languages on a document, that they can have no jurisdiction. They cancel each other out. So that means the people who we're talking about, pay attention. Need y'all to hold on to this, because this is going to let you know that Mr. Wen Miller was correct. David Wen Miller, the one that they took out, he was correct. He was 100% correct when he talked about... now, see, dang it, I can't even come up with the word in my head because it just slipped me, and it's right on the tip of my tongue. Syntax grammar. Because he's saying, wait a minute, you can't put those words together like that. That's not proper syntax. English is a precise language. It is a communication language, and you have to communicate the correct way. I understood exactly what David Miller was saying. Ladies and gentlemen, I got what he was saying. I understood syntax grammar. I get it. The problem is, those of you who studied under David and under his tutelage and the people around him, you don't know how to explain this when you go into a court. You're telling them that their document, blah, 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 and it isn't a real contract, blah, 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 and it has this error and that error. Ladies and gentlemen, first of all, if you look at our contracts, we have a statement in there, and that statement is put there intentionally, that the contract is to be construed contextually. Just that, and if any portion of the contract is deemed or held to be invalid, it does not invalidate any other portion of the contract. You follow me? So that even, pay attention to the statement. If any portion of the contract is deemed or held to be invalid, it does not invalidate any other portion of the contract, which means even if any other portion of the contract was deemed and held to be invalid, it would not invalidate the parts that are deemed and held to be invalid otherwise. You know, if there is another section deemed and held to be invalid, it's not invalidated by that statement. That statement goes ahead and validates that. Oh, by the way, a contract, if two people agree to the contract, then they agree to the language of the contract. That's how you get around that, because it's a private agreement. But we're going to continue. But if there are two different languages on a document, when you go to court, did you know that there are two different languages on every document in the court? You have legalese mixed with English. 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 You have legally, I'm sorry, mixed with English.
But what we could never really work out, or the illiterate, is that we assumed that this writing here was a part of the English language and could be read as English. But according to this book, it's American Sign Language, ASL, and it is found in languages other than English, in foreign languages, which renders this as a foreign language. And as this pelican here claimed that it was an older code, ancient Latin, and Monkey Phil, he knew exactly what it was.
I like it. I like the fact that he corrected the video because he called him a pelican when it's a penguin. And so I like the fact that he did that. But pay attention, ladies and gentlemen. That is a sign. And when it's on a sign, that is sign language. It is not English. Can you read the sign? Ladies and gentlemen, you guys walk into these buildings and they have posted these notices. They are signs. And you can't read the notice. My goodness.
It was American Sign Language and had nothing to do with English. That's why he read it as sign language, and the other monkey translated it to English, which is a clear statement stating that that is a foreign language.
Ladies and gentlemen, when you're in court, the monkeys, I'm not joking, the monkeys are there to interpret the signs. That is the attorneys. That's why they have them there. Those are your monkeys. They're supposed to interpret what the judge is saying. Now, you know that sometimes the interpretation can't be the same because you don't understand their language. So how can you tell them what they're saying and what they're not saying? Every time they tell you something, you're supposed to be asking the question. So wait, are you saying blah, 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 blah? Are you saying that if I say yes, then they could put me in jail. But if I say no, they could still put me in jail? No, there's got to be another option. What are the options for me not going to jail? That's right. What are the options for me not going to jail? Let me know what those options are. All right, then I'll consider all of it at that point. Yeah, because I can't handle that being the only option. One second.
What does this mean? Two languages appearing on one document. Well, it's the point of fraud.
Whoa! He said it's a deception. Ladies and gentlemen, I hadn't watched this part of the video, so I didn't know he was going to highlight that point, two languages being on the same document. If you look at your court papers, there's English, pay attention, and there is legalese on the same document because you have the all caps information mixed with their legalese Latin combination English language known as legalese or legal terminology, and then you have English. Uh-oh. Apparently somebody's trying to deceive you. One second.
When one is passing off a document to an unsuspecting victim that does not grammatically read what such a document is assumed to convey, such an act of passing off a document that is not what it is an act of counterfeiting. Such an act of fraud could be deemed as the evidence that our government and our bank are not our government or bank. It could be an international counterfeit government.
Now, hold on. That statement right there, it's understandable and it's something that I can even hold on to and agree with. However, I can't find it in no law. But let's go. You can look up counterfeiting or counterfeited document. But, you know, I don't know.
So you've got to be very careful and keep your eyes and your ears and be very vigilant when these Hollywood blockbusters come out, because the communist system gives us notice in these art forms. They claim that they gave us notice. They claim they've told us everything. And they sort of have told us everything. Just that we have to be awake. And
now, let me make sure you guys understand. I guarantee you, this young man has watched my videos, so I'm pointing you all to his, because I know for a fact that I have been saying from the beginning that there are laws, well, actually, it's not their laws that requires them to give you notice. It is the Bible. You see, the Bible said that the same law applied for the Jew as well as the foreigner or the Gentile who came into the midst of the nation of Israel. Same law, one people. Whether you were a foreigner or not, you were required to obey the same laws, follow the same laws, and abide by the same laws. Interesting, ain't it? So guess what happened with the Israelites? The priests, known as the Levites, were to read the law to the people. That's how they gave notice of the law. When Moses sat up there and wrote the law and then read the law to the people, everybody had notice. So nobody could claim ignorance. Everybody had notice. Because see, that's how the true God works. He makes sure that you are given notice. Because nobody wants to be able to claim ignorance. Oh, is that where they get ignorance of the lies? No excuse. You better believe it, because you already had notice of that law. You are deemed to know the law. Why? Because they put the law in the Federal Registry. They put it in the Code of Federal Regulations. They put it in the U.S. Codes. Well, these are statutory edicts. They're not laws. That's right, but they still put them there. And if you should somehow become under the jurisdiction of those laws, you are stuck. So, ladies and gentlemen, I'm not going to finish watching this video with you guys, because you guys can go and watch it yourselves. We can go watch it. You can go watch it yourselves. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, what I did is right after I found the individual told me about this video, I went and I looked. And then I went to the Chicago Styles Manual because I wanted to get a copy of that Chicago Styles Manual. Ah, I've done the 16th and the 17th edition I got off of this page. That's 16th, 17th up there, and it's also right here. The other one was from like a college or something. Forgot which college it was, but they're Gutenberg. I forgot what college it was. I don't know if this is a PDF, but the edition, the 15th edition, I'll take it. But I got the 16th and the 17th. There's another one, Landmark. There's an actual college called Landmark. Who would be so stupid to call their college Landmark? Oh, God. That landmark's the spot, mama. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, University of Chicago Style Manual. Pay attention. I thought it was Chicago Style Manual, meaning for the city of Chicago. But this is a university style manual. Okay, so let's see. Yeah, it's from, I need to find the actual download button. Because I think it's up there, but I think there should be a different download button. Download. Ain't no different download button, doo-da. Ain't no different download button for anybody. So give me a second, y'all. I was going to find me a download button. We're going to go right here. Uh-oh. Can't put my mouse on it.
I can't put my finger on it, y'all. But I know something's going on here that shouldn't be going on.
See, in that citation, I know. Open EEOWW. Chicago Style Manual. Hey, email this book. I could have emailed that book to myself. But I clicked on open. Open. Chicago Style Manual. 15th edition. Ladies and gentlemen, I am not interested in anything other than two languages on the same document. Ladies and gentlemen, how many documents do we have that they have English and Spanish and Asian? You said Asian. Asian is not a language. You know what I mean. The different languages of the Orient or the different languages of the Eastern countries.
Are you sure? Because it sounds like you're being a little racist there. No,
I am trying to cover every single angle and aspect of saying the same thing. You know what I mean. I meant what I said. Now, sorry. I have a very fond affection for my people who are Eastern descent. Also Middle Eastern descent. Why? Because they are different.
Are you trying to... Oh, I think that's the racist, most racist thing you ever said.
Why? They come from different cultures, and I admire most of the cultures of the East and of the Middle East. The cultures, I think, are unique, and I like them. I like the stick-to-itiveness. Now, we think that they're actually sticking to their cultures. It's no, they're not sticking to their cultures. That is their culture. That's what they grew up. That's how they grew up. They're supposed to follow their culture. And so that's what I see. So, ladies and gentlemen, so that this video, there we go. It did download the manual. Look how long it took, because it's a big book. Y'all saw how thick that book was, didn't y'all? Allo, we're getting ready to take us on out of here. Ladies and gentlemen, Allo Black. People say I'm foolish, and people say I'm blind in my face. Sorry. Hello, Black, everybody. I promise you, I really do care a lot about this song. I was waiting for it every day to come on the radio. Okay? It's like an anthem for me. Every single.
People say I'm foolish. People say I'm drowning in my face. I don't care. I'm gonna do it my way. Now, this is Internet Download Manager. Okay? And it works for me. It lets me download, and it's pretty quick, as you saw. So, Internet Download Manager, ladies and gentlemen, let's see if we can talk. I would open them up, but there's no reason because we're not going to be going over that. You're going to go over that in your spare time. See, I'm not doing this video so we can cover the full litany of that information. Oh, I care about you. So why don't you care for me like I care about you, girl? I care about you. Ladies and gentlemen, this is KC and JoJo. This is that government site I went to yesterday because I have my, what is that thing? My VPN? It ain't gonna let me. All right, so we ain't worried about that. What I want is this right here so that we can get to, not that one. I think we're going to this one. See, style manual, library style manual. We're going to go to this one. Okay, let me put you guys on pause while we get there. I'll listen to KC. I care about you, so why don't you care about me too? Now, you see how this thing is locked? There's a way to unlock it, okay? So I can edit if I want to. But they said, see, this is only 200 and, what you call it, pages, 217. So this is a different one than the one that he was looking at. So what we do is Control F, and we do SIGNLANGUAG. Come on now. It may not be able to find the words because the words may not be readable. But it looks like the words are readable. Okay, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, let me explain to you something. This thing is locked. Okay, so what I do... You're not home by design. And then we... Save as. Okay, I'ma go here. Hopes that you would do what? Girl, I care about you. Okay, and what I wanna do, I think we're gonna save it as a doc. Now it may not let me because it's locked, but there is a way to do it, and I think this might be it. Nope, it won't let me save it as a doc. No permission. So there is a way for me to save it. You know what? I know what to do. Sometimes I'm not. I'm all I've got. Sometimes. Now, you see what I just did? I'm saving it as a different PDF so that it'd be mine. And then I'll be able to do it all over again and take care of that. That's... Uh-oh. Conversion. That's what I want you to do. You got two errors. I don't mind your errors. Just keep going. Oh, it wouldn't let me do it. I'm going to have to do it the other way. So it's going to take me a minute, but it's going to be unlocked so I can take care of my business. Ladies and gentlemen, uh-oh. Wait a minute. This is supposed to be taken care of. Uh-uh. I know how to take care of that. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, I gotta go. Gotta go take care of some business. Let you guys go take care of your business. I'm just glad that you allowed me to show you that two languages on a document invalidate the entire document. Interesting, ain't it? Gotta go take care of yourselves. But remember, like KC and JoJo said, I care about you. KC, JoJo, and baby face. Okay? Gotta go. Take care of yourselves, everybody.